Hello everyone, thanks for joining me for this month's Reef Health Update. While the change of season brought cooler conditions to the Great Barrier Reef, sea surface temperatures remain above the long-term averages, although fortunately not at the level where heat stress accumulates, causing coral bleaching. Conditions in the Pacific have also changed, with the El Niño event giving way to neutral conditions. The Bureau of Meteorology forecasts that sea surface temperatures will remain above the long-term average over the coming months, though we may see a transition to La Niña conditions towards the end of the year. As we reported, we're continuing to work with our partners, particularly from the Australian Institute of Marine Science and James Cook University, to evaluate the effects of the mass coral bleaching event that we reported on the Great Barrier Reef back in March. As previously noted, the aerial surveys of more than 1,000 reefs showed widespread coral bleaching across all three regions of the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park, but at varying levels, depending upon largely reflecting the patterns of heat stress that we'd seen accumulate over the summer and early autumn months. A dominant impact on the reef this past summer has actually been coral bleaching driven by heat stress. There have actually been other impacts as well, largely stemming from the wind, wave and flooding damage associated with Tropical Cyclone Jasper in December and Tropical Cyclone Kirrily. Combined effect of those cyclones affected reefs, particularly in the northern and central region of the park. We now have something like 8,500 in-water surveys spanning 270 plus reefs, along with 60,000 images that are currently being analysed by the research teams. This information has been gathered by a combination of the research teams, the tourism industry, the Crown of Thorns Starfish Control Program, and our field rangers. This combined information is critically important in helping us to understand what's happened on the reef, and particularly the combined effects of these particular pressures. We will be looking to the Australian Institutes of Marine Sciences long-term monitoring reports, subsequent monitoring reports, to actually document the long-term consequence of these events in their long-term monitoring record. Overall, preliminary results that have been revealed so far show that we have, as reported, widespread coral bleaching, but we also for the first time have mortality and coral bleaching recorded in all three areas of the park. This in some ways, unfortunately, isn't a surprise, given that the heat stress that affected the Great Barrier Reef this year is actually unprecedented in probably all areas of the marine park, and most severely in the southern area of the Great Barrier Reef. The patterns of coral bleaching that we're seeing in the shallows from the aerial surveys and in the in-water surveys across coral communities and at depth is actually consistent with these patterns of heat stress. We also recorded coral mortality on several of the reefs, particularly in the areas that are most severely affected by heat stress. But this has been highly variable depending upon which aspect of the reef was most affected by heat stress. So we've particularly seen mortality in shallow water areas on the most stressed reefs, but we've also seen some mortality in the depths. But again, because of the sheer size of the Great Barrier Reef, this patterns have been actually variable depending upon where the heat stress was accumulated to the most degree. We're very fortunate the Great Barrier Reef is as large as it is and as resilient as it is. That's been documented in the patterns of recovery that have been seen following other large events such as the 2016 and 2017 mass coral bleaching events and subsequent coral bleaching events. While the patterns of recovery that were recorded over the past few years certainly demonstrate that the resilience of the reef is still intact, the increasing pressures of climate change mean this is going to be increasingly challenged, heightening the need for global action on climate change, along with all the local scale actions that we are currently taking in order to protect its future for future generations. You can find out more about the actions that are being taken to protect the Great Barrier Reef, and you can also get involved by downloading the Eye on the Reef app and telling us what you see when you're out in the marine park. With that, thank you for your attention. I'll look forward to bringing you more information next month.